A bill penalizing political turncoatism is filed at the lower house. The author, former Philippine president and now senior deputy speaker Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Under the proposed measure, party members are not allowed to switch affiliation 1 year before or after any national elections. Violations will have a penalty of forfeiting their elective office or disqualification from the next election. They also cannot be appointed or hold any government post. The Political Party Development Act of 2022 also seeks to institutionalize political parties and prescribes procedures for its registration before the Philippine poll body.
Do the right thing and protect democracy. Those are the marching orders of newly appointed Commission on Elections Chairman George Garcia. Garcia also revealed his priority policies in the poll body as he presided over his first virtual unbanked meeting.
Sa akin lang po, sinabi ko nga po na bilang bagong kapitan ng Commission on Election, hindi naman po siguro pwede na kung ano lang yung nadatnan ko, itutuloy lang. Kinakailangan po kung ikaw ay medyo visionary leader o medyo proactive na leader, kinakailangan base sa naging obserbasyon ko nung ako'y naandito, at the same time kung ano yung mga sa karanasan ko ay dapat na baguhin, kinakailangan po yung structural reforms na tinatawag natin good governance ay hanggang sa mga susunod. Ibig sabihin, kung may darating na bagong chairman and commissioners in the future, kinakailangan yung institutionalize na ang lahat.
A Philippine Catholic bishop calls for a boycott of the movie Made in Malacañang. Bishop Gerardo Alminaza described the film as shameless and called on the people behind it to publicly apologize to the Carmelite nuns, to President Corazon Aquino's family, and to the Filipino people. The movie's trailer portrayed the late President playing mahjong with a group of nuns. Aquino sought refuge at the Carmelite monastery in Cebu during the 1986 EDSA People Power Revolution. While the nuns depicted in the film were not wearing the Carmelites' brown religious habit, the congregation said the allusion to them is, quote, too obvious for anyone not to see. This also peeved a Benedictine nun, Mother Mary John Mananza.
Hindi nakakagalit. It is ridiculous, ridiculous, as in out of this world yung ginawa nila, no? Kasi, my goodness, yung Carmelite sisters pa naman are contemplative. Mas stricto pa nga sila kesa sa amin na active, no? At talagang all of their time is spent in praying. That time na namimiligro ang buong bayan, magmamadyong ka, ano ba naman? Sobra namang distorted ang imagination niya gumawa ng pelikula na yan. At that time, they were making fasting, abstinence, adoration, sacrifices for the country. Talagang it is so abominable, if I can say that.
Bishop Alminaza challenged the movie and television review and classification board, which is under the office of the president, to act on the issue and exercise its mandate.
Uncalled for, that's how Philippine Senator Aimee Marcos described criticisms against the Made in Malacañang movie. Marcos served as creative consultant for the film about her family's last days before fleeing the presidential palace. The center invites critics to watch the whole movie first before making any judgment. The president's sister also debunked reports they are giving away movie tickets to schools and local governments.
Bakit may komentaryo na sa lahat? Hindi pa napapanood? Kasi ngayon pa lang ang opening day. Ngayon pa lang ilalabas sa sinehan. Kaya naanyayahan ko kung ano man ang panig ninyo sa politika, paniniwala ninyo sa iba't ibang mga politiko. Mas importante siguro makita muna para malaman kung ano nga ba ang sinasaloob nitong sineng to. Lahat yan na binibili, kaya nga lang maraming sektor na nag-volunteer kagad at humingi ng black screening. Yun yung mga pinamimigay na ticket, pinamimigay sa empleyado, sa staff, sa kamag-anak. Marami na ring loyalista, siguro bahagi na doon yung mga bumoto ng 31 million.
Forty-six bills were left by the Duterte administration to lapse into law. Philippine Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles points this out as she refutes claims by a senator that President Marcos Jr. carried out what he referred to as a veto spree. Cruz Angeles says that out of the 46 measures that lapsed into law in July, only five were vetoed by President. Senator Francis Escudero earlier called on Marcos Jr. to avert what he called a veto spree by immediately appointing a high-caliber cabinet member to head the Presidential Legislative Liaison Committee.
41 bills lapsed into law and only 5 were vetoed. Hindi kasama dun sa 41. So it's not a spree. So tinotono lang naman ng ating Pangulo dun sa mga sistema yung mga batas natin. So lalong-lalo na yung mga batas that involve some kind of tax break or tax benefits, itotono mo dun sa ating polisiya of tax reform.
Among the measures which lapsed into law is a bill that provides for the creation of a penal facility for heinous crime convicts that would be similar to that of Alcatraz in the United States. It aims to have the facility built in a location isolated from the general population, preferably within a military camp or in an island.